All right. Well, we were here before and we saw a couple TVs. And I believe there was one in, was it this house? There were two TVs here, and let me find the first one and get out of the wind, and I will I could swear it was in Well, after a minute they all look the same. Alright, I think this was the first one. And there it is, right there. So, RCA, talked to the owner of this property who lives here, and he, graciously said I could come back and test these. So what did we bring? We brought in this pocket, we have a 12 volt lead acid battery. In this pocket we have an inverter. Okay. And here we have our CRT tester. So the first thing I want to do, and I apologize for the wind noise, I can't help that. It seems like it's been nothing but windy out here in California for this whole damn year, and I'm a bit sick of it. First thing we want to do is take a look at this. The coloring of that rear gun assembly to see if it's a different color. And got a little bit of duty cycle there. As you can see, actually it's just best with no, as you can see, this thing looks like it would be in good shape. There's no discoloration to that at all. Let's check it. All right, got that going there. We got power here, and that doesn't look good. The pretty sure I got that in there right. When I plug that in, you should see that drop, indicating there's a load on it. And so highly possible or probable that one of these leads is broken off in here. And at home, I would pull the socket off and look, but out here in an abandoned house, I can't really do that. Let me play with it for a minute. Yeah, the filament is open on that or not making contact. There was another one in one of these other houses out here. Let me see if I could find that. It was in one of the stucco houses, I think. It's like the sun's about to go down. So we got one more here that was in bad shape too. But hey, This is something different, guys. Okay, I believe it was in one of these here. So how about this right here for a clothesline? Check that out. Is that like hardcore enough for a clothesline? There it is. The last damn house in the friggin' row. Anybody home? TV service is here. Anybody home? Here to inhale asbestos and rock wool and take a look at your set. See if we could get your set working again so your family can watch product placement. Man, this is in bad shape. Oh, geez. 274, isn't that RCA? Wow, someone Clarko Snorfulated all the vacuum bulbs out of it. Oh, geez. Yep, RCA Kinescope 21 AMP4A. Yep. Oh, crap. So, like, savor this accumulation of rat feces in the bottom of this thing. Is that gorgeous or what? I mean... Looks good. Doesn't look all blue. Alrighty then. Let's get this hooked up and see how our valve bulb picture unit is. So I just want to step back and get some footage of that right there, because this right here, this is something you're never going to see anywhere else. You're never going to see that picture anywhere else. Dial in on that a little bit. Well, I got good news on this one. We have filament load. You can see that it's pulling down our voltage there. So let's bring this up to 5 volts. Or so. It's possible that it's gone to... Oh! Hello! Now, how about that? This sucker has been sitting for... who knows how long, and that thing just popped back right. I mean, look at that. It's 900 microamps. It's almost 1 milliamp. That's in good shape. It's too bad all of these vacuum bulbs are gone. You know, I wonder if this thing would... I wonder if there's any chance this would work. This would be an interesting video to see if we could get this to work, but just as wet and as rusty as it is, I just have my doubts. What happens when the IF coils and tuner and stuff get all rusty inside? Every tube socket's going to be crusty. Picture bulb is good though. Look at that. Let's go down to 5 volts. I wouldn't expect this stuff to have a whole lot of hours on it out here. I wouldn't expect these sets to have had their life run out of them. This is an old abandoned company town that has a guy that owns it and has a caretaker here. Now let's go down even lower. Let's go down to that's as low as it'll go. It's dropping. Anyway, that's good CRT. I hear that there's a TV graveyard out here. When they emptied these houses out, unfortunately, they took all these sets and just all the appliances and sets and just dumped them out in the middle of the desert. So I'm going to go take a look, try and find that. The owner said that I could take this TV if I wanted it. I got to think about it. It's not appetizing to drive home with that content in my vehicle. So, excuse me. All of these are frozen. It's tempting to take that and do a video and see if we could get that to work. It really is. You know, as long as the power transformer, the flyback, and the picture tube are good, you have a chance. Because you can always bypass the tuner and the IF and all that and feed composite video directly into the detector, so long as the yoke is good. You know, as long as your deflection circuits are good, you know, I don't know, it's tempting. It would sure be a record setter, though. I mean, I have a lot of faith in RCA, but this would really be testing the, and you know, I'm not worried about the feces as much as I am the rock wool, the lead paint, the asbestos tile, all the other, you know, flavorful, nutrient-filled dietary supplements that are in that TV. So this place probably closed up in the mid-70s. So there probably were no solid-state sets out here ever. Everything would have been tube. Because they were still making tube sets up into about 74, 75. I've even seen some hybrid stuff up into 78. Japanese stuff. Trying to get rid of those leftover parts. So anyway, the sun is just about gone there. And let's go down and take a look at that dump, TV dump. Alright, I guess this is where they were talking about. I see some sets here. Boy, is this sad. Should we test this CRT? You know what? That damn thing is, it's not dark at the back. Look at this one. Same thing. That is not all blued. Well, look, it has a brightener on it. Cracked. Wow, that's sad. This is rare. This is rare to find a Japanese man. Oh, man. Wow. All I can say is wow. Product of RCA. That might have to come home. Something over there. Admiral? like a 3. I would grab all these vacuum bulbs. The problem is when they get wet like this, they go to air when you heat them up. You just never know. That's a walk. Electric walk. That was an All-American 5. There's the clock. You know, I bet I could make this work. In fact, you know what? This might just have to come home with me. This is really sad. I have to set these here. Freon 22. All right, let's take a look at what I hauled back from the old abandoned company town and trash dump, vintage e-waste facility. And I don't know why, but I just had to bring this stuff home. I think it would be interesting to try and make it work again if we got enough working good key components. So I grabbed this, and it's going to be a bit of forensics to even figure out what that is. The GE radio, I grabbed it. It's only missing one tube. As long as the IF transformers and the audio output transformer are good in that, a new speaker. Zoom in on that real quick. Let's dial that in. How's that looking? A new speaker should get that going and go through it and figure out, see if we could get it to work. The problem with this stuff is going to be rusty tube sockets. And if the water got in the IF transformers and ruined the mica. And this thing, which is interesting, I don't know why this is like this. This is an old RCA. I could probably pull the back off of this and check the bulb picture tube and see if it's any good. And then I got the big one. We'll take a look at that. Still in the truck here, but this is the one that the tube tested good on. Put some gloves on and kind of scraped all the rat crap out of it and got it in here. Need to figure out what the chassis number is on this, the KCS number, and then I can start to slowly, I'll soak the controls with oil. I was thinking PB Blaster, but the problem is that stuff might just strip the carbon right out of the pots. That's some wicked stuff. I need the KCS number off of this, and then I can start to slowly acquire the tubes. What, there is a tube chart. Maybe I'll pull it out and we'll take a look at that. But these will be upcoming projects, I guess, when I get in a mode where I need to be punished. Let's dial in on that right there. That's pretty cool. All right, here's a look in the back. And I don't see the KCS number. RCA black and white chassis all started with KCS. And I'm going to guess this is around a KCS 100 plus or minus, say, 15. It's probably higher than 100. But 274 is the EIA code for RCA. We know it's an RCA. I was thinking what I could do with this is fix it one, or get it going one stage at a time. Maybe do one video on each stage. So start with a video, get the horizontal output going first in high voltage, then the vertical going, then the video going, then the IF going, then the tuner going. I kind of have a goal with this. There's the person that owns this property where this town was, it is private property where I got this, is a huge fan of one of the current people running for president. And I think it would blow his mind to show some video on this TV of that person, you know, if that person doesn't get assassinated first. Look at a picture of this. Maybe I can figure out from this what it is. All right, what I'm gonna do for now is I'm gonna hose these shafts down. I've used this stuff before when resurrecting old TVs. This is, you get this at the gun store. It's for cleaning, and you spray your weapons after firing them with this. And you know, gunpowder is real corrosive, so you always need to clean your guns, and this stuff is kind of oily in that, and it will probably dissolve the rust really well. So we'll just put this on there and just let it soak for a while and see what happens. All right, let's check this out real quick. Like, I need another project. I still got to finish that hot point, but I attached my suicide cord here. Somebody had cut off the plug, not actually the cord, so I got that. Plug it into the watt meter. Now, keep in mind, this has probably been sitting outside in the desert, sun, wind, rain since the 80s. So, boy, we really got the key. 127 volts. Boy, it's really cranking today. It's usually right on 120. So let's go down to watts. Can't do this one-handed. All I did was plugged it in. Got nothing to lose. The power switch works. You gotta be kidding me. Do we think there's a little bit of dust in there? The back office and test the picture bulb. Holy crap, look at the inside of this thing. This has been out in the rain for damn near 30 years. Oh, there's a horizontal phase detector diode right there, and it's a GE too. It's probably bad. So something's broken here. Someone must have dropped it. Is this pulled away from the front? Okay, what is this? KCS... KCS 1... 184. KCS 1 something. And there is again is your 274, which is your EIA code. Let's test this. It's got some GE tubes in it, so it's been worked on. Wow. Check out that operation. Okay, this resistor just fell off, and it looks like it went from down in there to around to here. And this wire probably ripped out when they dropped it and that pulled away and this went up. It probably ripped this out. I bet this thing would... That's the video cable. This socket is so sun-baked that it's literally just coming apart as I unplugged it. And I was very gentle. Come on, baby. Show me some love. Kinda nobody home. For some reason, I don't know if I buy this. I wouldn't imagine that the life would be run out on this set. It'd be more likely that the tube was gassy. Check out the rain streaks on the back of the CRT, where the water's been pouring in. Just the fact that the thing turns on and comes up with static, like it's receiving audio and doesn't blow up and catch fire and isn't humming, is a real testament to the quality of the way things used to be made. Look at that transformer. Baked and crusty. Well, we're not really doing much here. And I'm not a fan of that whole let it cook, you know. As you've seen in my videos, even if it's been sitting for 40 years, if the tube is good, it should still come right up. I mean, I could try and blow it off with the rejuvenator. Maybe we'll do that in the next video sometime once the hot point's done and I get all caught up. I mean, yeah, at 8 volts, look at it, it comes right up to 1 milliamp. In fact, it comes up too high almost. I don't think I've ever seen one up that high. Also, this tester is not really reliable. It's not as accurate as the other tester. geez, it's almost like it just shorted out. I don't know, that seemed to have woke it up. Let me let it cool. Let me turn it off. Or here, interrupt switch. That was weird. It was almost like it was thermally shorted inside. I don't know, this thing's tripping out. Oh well, more to come later. Hope you enjoyed it. This has been a really random video.